Welcome back to Geek Cheese. My name's Kelly, and I'm back with The Last Door. So last time, we played with Greg, and we figured out a few things, which was good. So now we're trying to figure out this thing with this, repair guy, the handyman or whatever he is. So that's what we're trying to do now. Oh my god, I heard that coughing and I didn't know where it was coming from. This is probably gonna go up on Halloween, so happy Halloween. I think today, or when Halloween is, I'm recording this early, but I think, our trick-or-treat night is actually on Halloween, which is pretty cool. Okay, I think we need to go outside and talk to this guy. Okay. Let's talk to this guy. So we tried to distract him. We have to get this thing from his toolbox. So I'm thinking we have to distract him somehow. So, we tried different things. I'm gonna try to distract him by talking to him. Okay, wait. I don't think I can do that. That's not letting me. Oh, wait. Ooh, I got it. Makes sense. It says distracted. That makes sense why he said that. Okay. Alright, well, we got that. I wonder if we need to ask him this stuff again. Alright. Let's go take care of the guy in the coffin. Did I just go the right way? Oh man. What is that? Ah! The darkness of his eye. His body is petrified. He has a look of sheer terror in his eyes. Oh my god, but what has happened? Talk to me. I need to get like water. Should I hit him? Let's just go down this way and see if anything happened with that. None. I still can't pick any of that up. I wonder if we have to like throw water on him or something. Wait, is that the lady? Is that the lady from the front? Because then we can go in that office. Yes, it is. I'm recording. Yeah. I got the tool. You gotta talk to him. Yeah, you had to talk to the guy and then steal it while you were talking to him. So now that lady left, so now I can get into that room. I don't know. Let me see if you're in the way. I don't care, it doesn't matter. Okay. Oh no, I missed. Now you made me miss everything. Hold on. Oh, good lord. Okay. William Nee. Okay, these are all the people that died. Okay. William Nealand's November 13th. Cause of death. Cracklixa? Cacklixa? What's that? Scratch marks have been found in his stomach. Cacklixa. Lexia. Caclexia. That was the cause of death. I never heard of it. Elmer Moore. Pleuresia? A clear expression of terror on the patient's paralyzed face was found at the time of death. Evelyn Benzie. Typhoid. TB. Claude Harris, cause of death unknown. He died while he was sleeping. Morphine overdose. Okay, so Ellen Blair committed suicide. Oh, we got a key, Okay, let's go in this room. Nope, I need the key. Okay, let's go in the key. Yes. Uh-oh, what is this? What is this? Oh, boy. Uh-oh. Who's this guy? Don't look into his eyes. Don't look into whose eyes? Who are these people? Because the deepest darkness dwells in his eyes? What? Oh boy, I don't know if we should go in here. Come in, my son. Did you think you could hide these books from me? They are just classic philosophy books, father. Plato and Aristotle. Silence, instruments of falsehood, you mean? Fallacies coming from the snake. Now, son, get on your knees and praise and raise your arms. Oh my god, he's whipping me. Apologize to the Lord. Pray to the Lord. I don't know. Oh my god. I don't know what just... Somebody was being crucified? It is Latin. Malum in si. Evil in itself. A strange eye-shaped symbol. Ah! What was that noise? Oh! The glass is breaking. Oh boy. Eye of the bird. What does this mean? Ah! I'm scared. Okay.
I'm scared.
Eye of the bird. What does this mean? I don't know what it means. Why are there other crucifixes? And the windows keep breaking. Lord, your eyes burn me. I don't deserve mercy nor forgiveness. Oh Lord, have mercy on my soul. Who are you sending me? Is death to whom you are handing me over? Has my hourglass already run out of sand? Father Ernest. What is Cooper doing? It's only the Lord who teaches us. Get closer, son. Come pray next to me. The makeshift altar is coated in dense layer of wax. The candles have almost burned out, and barely illuminate with the moon. A creepy image of Christ crucified. Inexplicably, it has a dark cloth covering his head. Glory be to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. Now, my son, tell the Lord which one is his voice, the sharp sword, the wise quill of the delicate petal. I don't know. You're an Ella envelope by Sin? So I don't know if I made the wrong answers or... Okay, I still can't pick any of this stuff up. Upstairs and see if there's anything happening. I wonder what we're supposed to do with this log.
Is the log a snake? They have to like drive into somebody who knows. Is it a snake? They have to drive into somebody or somebody. Can you use the log in the tapestry?
No. Sure, what? I'm probably supposed to do something in here. need to be quiet so he can't hear us. Dear God in heaven, I feel for you. Your light is in my eyes. I will burn them for you. Dear God in heaven, I feel myself in you. Ugh, creepy. Okay. So we read that. I guess we don't need to... So now we have a razor. Ooh, I think we can cut the razor.
Oh, you can cut the tapestry.
Yeah.
I got really super excited, everyone. Sorry.
Okay. So now we can go up and try to cut the tapestry. Let's hurry, 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 hurry. Somebody broke the windows. I don't know who broke the windows. There's blood on it. I wouldn't be able to cut this so thick. So now we have to use... We made our own cutting tool. The log was for the razor. Yeah, oh boy, what's this? Ah! Ah! Scary! And finally, our expert on philosophy, Jeremiah Devitt. Where were you, my friend? We have been looking for you. Oh boy. Well, as I was saying, tonight's the perfect moment for our next meeting. I suspect that someone outside our group is secretly surveilling us. Who is it, Anthony? My dear friend, it is Professor Glynn. Do you mean Father Ernest? Certainly, no doubt about it. Therefore, dear colleagues, I have decided to change the venue for tonight's meeting. Have you noticed the lounge behind this small door of the classroom? I have believed convenient to borrow the key for necessities. You already know. At 12 o'clock, you will find that door opened, and I'll be inside the lounge. That is it, my dearest colleagues. I don't know what that means. A date or something. Oh boy, now where are we? I remember that in this furniture we used to keep some of our personal belongings. Now it's empty. The walls are in complete disarray. I could probably punch through it if I tried. I remember that this is the bed where I used to sleep when I was a student here. Oh dear lord, now what's happening? Ah, now we're in a creepy thing. Where are we? I think we're in a dream. Mr. Rabbit was jumping through the forest in a warm spring afternoon. What? What is this? When going through a bush, Mr. Rabbit ran into Mr. Wolf, Mr. Vulture, Mr. Snake, who were having a heated argument. Look at this! Creepy! Mr. Rabbit, curious as some dearest, why are you arguing in this beautiful and cheerful spring afternoon? Oh my goodness. Mr. Wolf answered politely, what are we trying to decide here? What we are trying to decide here is who of us will have the pleasure to eat you up. Mr. Rabbit, really scared, said, but I do not want to be eaten. I want to live. Mrs. Snake answered, smiling. That is impossible to happen, Mr. Rabbit, since we all, both you and us, are going to die sooner or later, don't you think so? Ah, there's like a figure. Mr. Vulture added. Mrs. Snake is right. We should stick to the issue at hand. It is getting late, and as you see, we do not agree. Do you want to help us decide, Mr. Rabbit, who you suggest as the one to eat you? I think there's a figure standing there or something. Maybe not. After thinking about it for a while, Mr. Rabbit came up with the idea and carefully said, I got it. Why not to organize a race? The first who arrives to the forest clearing will have the privilege to eat me. No doubt Mr. Wolf can run at high speed, but Mr. Vulture can go flying and avoid any obstacle. And I'm sure that Mrs. Snake knows all about shortcuts within the forest. What do you think? I think it's creepy. There's like definitely people in the windows. The three predators agreed that it was fair, so they started their race and they quickly disappeared. Mr. Rabbit, happy to trick them, started running at high speed in the opposite direction of the predators, who, eager to prove their worth, didn't realize the trick. Mr. Rabbit was far away from there, and he finally felt safe, happy, and proud of his cunning. But suddenly there was a loud bang. The earth shook, frightened birds flew, and everything went dark. And... ah! Okay. That's nice. Okay, let's just... why are they looking at me? Oh my god. An impossible love? There's something I kept to myself for a long time. And the thing is that I love you. I've always loved you. What the heck? This is like a silent movie all of a sudden. Since the first time I saw you, since the first time I felt your frozen hands. Yeah, she's from a... each time I move away from you, I miss your glassy, empty, dead eyes. She fell off a casket. I miss your rough hair, your grayish skin, your stench. Ew. She's in a casket. It is an impossible love. What the heck? The end? Oh my goodness. What a dream. No, not again. How long have I been sleeping? What was that all about? In the nightmare, I found a place in my memories. I guess there's nothing really to take from in here. Let's go back in here and see if there's anything else I can take. I like this song. This is some good music. Is this the outside? Okay, I think I was in here somewhere. Something about a door. Yeah, this is it. Okay. There's a trap door I saw in my nightmare. Oh boy. From here sprouts a horrible stench. There was something down there. Ew, what the hell? Did you see? Did you see? It was there, just in front of me. That thing, it was screaming. These dead bodies? He shakes uncontrollably, his body racked with pain, and there is only one way to end this suffering. The decayed corpse of a young woman. It seems as if she has been devoured by an animal. The stretchers used to carry the corpses here. Who is behind all this? Look at all the dead bodies. Walls are splattered with dried blood. Oh boy, what's this? Punctual as always, Devitt. Now all that remains is to introduce your guest. You may come in now, Professor. Father Ernest. Do not worry, my friend. I invited him to join us this evening. The professor genuinely shares our curiosity, and who better to complete our group than one of the most renowned theologists? Moreover, we mustn't ban those who are willing to explore beyond the veil. The moment we have long awaited has now arrived. Please, all of you, take a seat and we shall begin the procedure. Soon shall the door be open, and then may we finally see what lies beyond. Now I ask that you close your eyes. You will feel a momentary prick as I inject you with the serum. Oh my god. Some creepy stuff going on. Even after all these years, I have not forgotten your voice. You are the fourth witness. I remember now what happened. What is that we saw? The eye of the bird, Malum in Se? What happened to us? What is it that we witnessed? You must tell me. You must make me understand. My mind cannot fathom. It was our curiosity that damned us. We opened that which should not be opened, and in doing so, we shorn the veil that separated our world from his, and seeking vision, we were ourselves seen by the eye of the bird. It remembers us, it looks for us, it calls us from its dark nest, from its abominable lair. All these years, I have attempted to return to it, but I have no strength left. These poor, wretched creatures are too fragile. They lack the sight to return. Not one of them has, only us, the four witnesses. Where are the other two? Where are they? They disappeared as you did. I haven't heard from any of you, but I was seized by curiosity. It absconded with my faith and deprived me of sanity. Oh Lord, forgive me, for I have sinned. Nothing remains. All that is left is surrender. Surrender to him. Gravely have we sinned, and now our only absolution is to burn. To burn in the flames! Oh Lord. Ah! He's burning! He's set himself on fire! Ugh. Burned to death. Oh god, who's this? Ah! He just hit me in the head with a hammer! Oh my god. Oh my god, he's putting me in a coffin. He's putting me in a coffin! Oh god, I don't want to be stuck in a coffin. I don't want to be in a coffin. Oh my god, what's happening? What is that? They're digging my grave! I'm in a coffin and they're digging. I can hear the dirt pouring on me. What's wrong with these people? Who came up with this game? They're freaks! I'm just kidding. Oh my god, I'm buried in the dirt. The adventure continues in episode 3. The last door memories was okay. All right, guys. Well, I'm gonna leave it there. That was interesting. I think I'm pretty sure I'm buried in the dirt in the back of this place. I'm excited to see what happens though in episode 3. Check back for more. I'm gonna continue to play this. Subscribe and like this video, and I'll see you guys next time.